Now we're going to be looking at your shoulder joint, which is also known as a glenohumeral joint. Now, this is the most freely moving joint that we have in our body. We get extension, flexion, lateral rotation, medial rotation. We also have circumduction. So again, we have a enormous degree of freedom. However, that comes at the cost of stability. Now, this is a ball and socket joint. What it the two bones that we have articulating here are the humerus and the scapula. Now, the humerus, the head of the humerus, is articulating with the glenoid cavity of the scapula. And here's the where the issue is. We have a very large head over here, which is the head of the humerus, and the glenoid cavity. It's very shallow and it's small. So what ends up happening is you have like this big golf ball that's sitting on top of this tiny tee. So you're not going to be very stable. Great degree of motion, but there lacks stability. Now there is an articular capsule that's enclosing this cavity, but it's also thin and it's loose. What it does do is that it contributes to the freedom of movement that we have at this joint. So when you look over here in this illustration, this is the head of the humerus, and here's the your this is the scapula over here. So this head of the humerus, it sits within this cavity, this glenoid cavity. Now this is a synovial cavity of the glenoid cavity. So again, remember, synovial joint, you can have a synovial membrane. This is a chromium end of the scapula, and we can see the fibrous layer of this articular capsule over here, and then also the tendon of the long head of your biceps brachii muscle. And this is a very important muscle. This is a major muscle that helps stabilize this joint, along with your rotator cuff muscles. Please be sure to refer to the Pearson website for the ANP Flix to look at this animation. Very important that you do that. Let's look at this picture that they have of a cadaver. All right, so this is completely off over here. There's no synovial cavity over here. The synovial cavity you're going to find over here. And then this is articular cartilage that we have over here. Now the fibrous layer, yeah, you can see it also here, but this is where the fibrous layer is, part of the fibrous layer of this articular capsule. You can see over here, another part you can see over here. What you can see here is the humerus here and the scapula. Now, remember what we said earlier, that the glenoid cavity is shallow. What it has is it has this fibrocartilaginous collar that surrounds it, and this is called the glenoid labrum, and this helps add a little bit depth to the cavity. Problem is, even with this glenoid labrum there to aid the head of the humerus, only one third of that head it ends up fitting inside the glenoid cavity, including around this is the glenoid labrum. So how do you stabilize this joint? A lot of ligaments. So on the pr primarily on the anterior aspect, we have this coracohumeral ligament, and it helps support the weight of the upper limbs. There's also three glenohumeral ligaments, and they straighten the anterior capsule. However, they are they're a weak support, and in some individuals, they're absent. You may not even find them. So now let's look over here in this illustration, and you can see the tendon of the long head of the biceps brachii muscle again. Here's the transverse humeral ligament over here. This is the coracohumeral ligament over here. You have the coracoacromial ligament over here. This is the chromium end, and this is the I'm sorry, this is the chromium end, and this is the coracoid process. So between the chromium and the coracoid process, you have the coracoacromial ligament. This is a subscapular bursa. So the other thing is, again, when you look at those animations, you'll see that a lot of bursa. Remember, you have a lot of tendons over here, bones, a lot of motion. So you're going to have friction. So these bursa, remember, they're there to decrease the friction. And here's the tendon of a subscapularis muscle. So, and this is your scapula. Now here, this is a picture of your scapula. Okay, this entire picture here. Again, you can see the chromium end and the coracoid process. Now this is an articular capsule, and right over here, this is the glenoid labrum that we were talking about. Okay, so you can see it kind of acts like a collar. It goes around the rim of this glenoid cavity. So the reinforcing muscles that contribute to the most stability, is going to be your the tendon of the long heads of your biceps brachii muscle, as I said earlier. This is the super stabilizer muscle. The other muscles are your rotator cuff. Okay, now these are the subscapularis, the supraspinatus, the infraspinatus, and the teres minor. So when the tendons they come and they encircle the shoulder of these muscles, it also helps further stabilize this joint. But remember, your super stabilizer, the main one, it's going to be the tendon of the long head of your biceps brachii. So be sure you look at these animations again, either with the DVD that came with your book or on the website. Another animation and more pictures, illustrations that we looked at already. So this one we haven't looked at. So here, you can see over here the capsule of their shoulder joint. It's been opened. They ended up cutting these rotator cuff muscles over here to expose that. Here's the head of the humerus. You can see here, this is a glenoid cavity of the scapula. And you can see the glenoid labrum also over here. This is acromion, and it's been cut off. Again, to show you this view. Another video, please be sure to look at this as well. And another one, this one's going to be showing you some movement and also the muscles that are involved. Another video that's going to be showing you some more things, probably some rotator cuff muscles that we're looking at. This is the deltoid muscle, by the way. It's one of the largest muscles you have in your upper arm. Now we're going to be looking at your elbow joint.